Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever you are. This is Lê and we are in True IELTS. So today I would explain to you what it means to be creative thinker and how can we use that to in the context of IELTS. So whether you believe it or not, we are all creative by nature. I can put money on this. So let's think back to when you was a child. Actually, creative thinking is something which was encouraged in primary education, but later on in life, when we are taught to follow discipline and instruction, we are slowly discouraged to be creative. And the irony here is that creative thinking is the only thing that we can have during our life, and that's the thing that makes us different from any other individuals. Creativity is often associated with painting or sculpture or writing a novel, even fashion designing. Actually, it's in all aspects of life. The only thing is that creativity is not something spring into the mindset of IELTS teacher and students. Improving your creativity is about giving yourself a chance to express your idea in a much more straightforward message, and also how your idea can be brought together, be evaluated, or even come up with something new. That's the concept of creativity and creative thinking in the wider sense. For an IELTS speaking test, having a great sense of creativity can actually help you throw away answers which are repetitive, uninteresting, unimaginative, or in short, boring. So for example, you can say this, I really don't feel good right now. Or you can just say, I'm a second away from a devastated mental collapse. And straight away, the second answer makes much more visible sense for the listener, for the examiner. And also you have extra mark as well, because you really show off your collection of words and your choice as well. And that's how it really helps you to increase your score, which you actually can do without improving having a lot more vocabulary. Doesn't really matter. When you encounter a question or theory, do you accept it at face value or do you break it down using logic? Being able to think analytically is one of the most important skills that anyone can possess. And like many other skills, it's surprisingly easy to learn. So we talk about being creative, now we have to talk and understand what it means to be an analytical mode of thinking. And whenever talking about analytical thinking, people tend to think that it's all about logic, it's all about labyrinth type of skill. But the fact is, it's just wrong, because it's still the whole brain type activity. And people who we consider to be the most analytical thinking in this planet, the most logical thinking that you've ever met, can still be very creative. And analytical thinking does not spell the end of creativity, and it still have to be together, because when you have a lot of idea, that creativity, bring it into the context, bring it into the table. We need to analyze it, we need to screen it, we need to sort it out and decide which idea you want to bring forward into your argument. And this really helps you for your IELTS test as well, because you only have 150 words for the first writing and 250 words for the second writing IELTS. So your choice of idea must be a lot more sharp, creative, but analytical. So using analytical thinking can help us break down a series of chunk, raw and complex data and information. So for example, I have this IELTS writing test topic here. Let's have a look. So obviously, you have a look at the the topics. There is actually two tasks that we have to follow today, and we can do it so well using analytical thinking. So the first task is to recognize what the topic is about. So obviously it's about the different level of income between people who work in the sport profession and people who working in another industry, which is obviously very important as well. And the second important task is to identify the task requirements. So it is for us to present different point of arguments before presenting your personal opinion. So we all understand that task and this step up to this point. The difference between what to do and how to do it in a really constructive way is a different story, which analytical thinking can help you to master this. Do you want to learn how to be analytical thinker and how to apply this set of skill into an IELTS test? So in this ACC technique, the other C stands for critical thinking. And in order to understand fully what critical thinking is about, we need to distinguish between critical reading and critical writing. In IELTS reading, we would be given three different pieces of article, which are very complex in grammar, in vocab, and also in information. And it's highly important for us to be able to speed reading and read between the lines to grasp the most important, the key point that the writer trying to give us. And critical reading is, like I said, the most effective way for us to do so. Also, in order to serve the purpose of IELTS writing as well, we would have to do extra reading a lot in different type of topic. And we cannot just pick whatever information that we have. It's so essential for us to be critical, to choose what type of information that we think really serve the purpose of our writing. And for that, arrange all of that in a very logical way. So in IELTS writing, the argument must be put forward and be supported by a statement of fact. The problem is that to a lot of Vietnamese students, we are lack of the ability to distinguish between statement of fact and statement of opinion. For example, eating a lot of sugar is bad for health. That's a statement of opinion. Eating a lot of sugar can increase your chance to be suffer from diabetes. It's more like a statement of fact. Can you see the difference? So if you use a lot of statement of fact to support your main idea, then it's a lot more supportable, a lot more persuasive, and you get more score from that as well. Producing a piece of critical writing is not only required for IELTS, but it also what is really essential during the course of your study life. And would you want to develop your critical thinking? Please join me in True IELTS. Thank you.